also I extend a warm and welcome to all our Naga precious men and women. Here I stand before you as president of NCF. Today, as NCF fellowships include you all to this fellowship and family. And I encourage all of us to add here to the sensitivity and the discipline the best on our Naga culture with social and spiritual awareness and responsibility.
Come to us, we need not to compare. Let's all unite to love each other as Jesus did.
Few months, but we are here, and I believe that all of us have responded to the call of God. God has called each one of us to be in the part of His kingdom.
This is your sub laga tibendo apni laga pupitra atma laga anointing mangina prabhu restitution. Ajib.
But within a short period of time, we fill this place. at home, far away from home. We praise God for blessing us with this beautiful home, with new churches, pastors, and all the people over here. I also want to thank every one of you, you know, for encouraging us and building us in every way. And everything has been made so far to adapt here and to feel like a home because of the kind gesture, the healthy environment, and the right advices of our pastors, our neighbors, our college lecturers, and all the executive members. I have no words to express except a big thank you to you all for everything that you have done for us so far. I believe and hope that, you know, we'll have a good time here, and we are truly excited to learn, to grow, and to serve together with you all.
If you want to be, make it short time, African Morombra, all of you have to be I need enough space. Kilaman space mo ikani entertainment group ko nyo tuno paribo so. Bia nova bin all freshers come to picture the jai bin and new freshers can be to be come forward and I
the colleges. You see most of you, especially the youngsters, you resemble this young rich man in many ways. You are all very young, and you have lots of questions and doubts in your heart, in your mind. You are all rich, I wouldn't say materialistically, but you are all rich because you want to do so much for the Lord. You want to do so many good things, and you want to learn so many things. And also it could be that you have set your heart and mind on something which you are not able to let it go. It could be in your character, in your qualities, or it could be in your possessions. And also, you are all rulers, not of the land, but of your own heart. You rule your own heart, you will rule your own soul, and you want to do everything on your own terms. This is a time when people will give advices, but you will not listen. You will try to take decisions in your own understanding, and you will also try to face the consequences that comes along the way. Sister Esther has already read it for all of us. But we have to find that Jesus was on the way to Jerusalem. And as he was about to start his trip, a young man came running towards him. He came running towards Jesus and he knelt down and he asked, "Good teacher, what should I do to get eternal life?" We can see the urgency of this young man. He came running towards Jesus and he knelt down. And he came straight to the point. He did not go around the bush. He came straight to the point. In many passages in the Bible, you will find that people come to Jesus and they ask questions, not to learn from him, but to find fault in him, trap him through some very complicated questions about life and about the Bible, about the Word of God. But here we find that this young man was very, very anxious. He was in a very urgent state, and he came running to Jesus with full respect. He came to Jesus, he knelt down, and with full respect he said, "Good teacher." And he asked a question, which every one of you here in this room must have asked one time in your life. Because this question, according to studies, have shown that this is one of the most asked questions in the world. This question is, according to studies, is among the top 20 most asked questions and most big questions of life. So not only you, but the whole world is asking about this question. What should I do to get eternal life? Every religion talks about it. Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Islam. And we know what they all say about it. And in the same way, even now, some of you here in this room must be asking the same question. And if you are, then I'm glad to tell you that you have come to the right place. Because the answer is in Jesus Christ. Even the young man had come to the right place. And he asked the question to the right person in Jesus Christ. So now when we see that Jesus he came and asked the question, Jesus did not directly answer the question at the first go. But instead he asked him, "Why do you call me good? Only God is truly good." Verses, it says, except God alone.
So here Jesus answers him by pointing to him that the quality of goodness comes from God alone. Following in the ways of the Church of Laodicea, following in the ways of this young ruler. See, we need to examine our hearts, because we have to see whether our life is following a lukewarm approach or not. And if it is, then it's time that we totally and fully commit our lives to Christ. So this young ruler asked Jesus a question on eternal life, and Jesus showed him the way. But we find that he would not take. He did not take it, because for him, wealth, possession was too much. The sacrifices were too great for him. And he just could not surrender, and he failed to commit his heart to God. And he went away sad and heavy-hearted. You see, Jesus never asked his disciples, who were fishermen, to sell their boats and their houses and follow him. No. Jesus never asked his other rich followers to do the same. No, he did not. But Jesus knows our hearts. Jesus knows our needs. And he also knows what are the things that are holding us back. What are the things that are holding us from fully committing our heart to Christ? And Jesus wants us to throw all the idols that we are hiding in our heart. He wants us to throw all of it. Some of the idols we are secretly hiding somewhere in the corner of our heart. God wants us to throw it away and follow him wholeheartedly. I'm still very, very young. About it before I die, let me come to Christ. But I tell you, years just flies away. It's time for you to get married. Before you know it, you have a kid, and the kid's growing so fast. Before, I genuinely need that I need to do more. Sometimes I used to just wonder about it and think that, what have I done in this almost 40 years of my life? It's never too early to start for the Lord. If you are young, that is the best part.
Amen.
You can do so much for the Lord.
Amen.
When you grow old, you will feel that you have really misused your time for the Lord. And so I want to encourage you, that especially the youngsters, make a commitment to serve the Lord wholeheartedly in whatever works you are doing. It doesn't mean that I have to be a missionary to serve the Lord. No. Everyone is a missionary in your own way.
Yes.
But not necessarily you need to be a Bible teacher or something, you know. We can all serve God in our own capacity, in our own ways.
Yes, yes.
So you see, this is the right time for you to surrender your dreams, your ambitions to God. Because he knows the best of all of us. Thank you.